Welcome back, guys. So this is episode 2 in this Mainstage series. And in this video, I'm going to be teaching you how to map a Mainstage to your Nano KorgKontrol. Okay, so welcome back. So right where we left off, there's some new things on the screen. I'm going to explain them quickly and we can get to mapping stuff. So the one new thing that's on the screen is these buttons right here. So these buttons are going to help me switch between each patch basically, and you can get them from obviously going to panel controls and then dragging button from here onto there and then resizing them, and that's basically it. Okay, so let's start with mapping stuff. So by mapping, I really mean connecting stuff, right? So first you click this volume fader and you click your Korg Nano Control. Go on your Korg Nano Control, click assign, move it up, move it down. And yeah, you do that for every single one. Go through each button, make sure it's mapped properly. And then, yeah, so I'm just gonna do that for all 7, and I'm gonna be back soon. Okay, so welcome back, guys. I have successfully mapped each fader to its like correct thin. And also, do not forget to map these buttons. So your panic button and also these buttons that you're going to use to switch between patches. So now for the fun stuff. So first you're going to plug in your piano, obviously, just so that it recognizes it. So you click on your piano, click on which one it is. I already have that there, so it's my Casio. And very important, this right here helps it learn what your lowest key is. So for example, I'm gonna click on learn and I'm gonna hit my lowest key. So that's good. And I'm gonna hit my highest key. We'll click on learn. Oh, sorry. Yeah, so just do your lowest key, don't do your highest key, and then now it knows where everything is basically, and you should be fine. And as you can see, as I hit my keyboard, the MIDI button lights up. So that shows that like stuff is actually working out. So that's good. Okay, so now to the fun stuff where we attach sounds to the faders and let it control volume. So for that, we go to edit. Great. Okay, so if you remember from the last episode, I had 2 more patches here. I deleted them because any change or setup change you make to one patch, it doesn't transfer to the other patch, to the other patches. So I usually prefer to do it on one patch, and then when I'm done, I right click or hit the mouse with 2 fingers and I click duplicate, and then that way my settings switch over. When you duplicate, you can always go and rename it by double clicking. So that's fine. I'm just gonna delete this. Okay, so with every main stage patch that's gonna come, it's already gonna have a sound there, right? So I'm just gonna add 3 more sounds, and then yeah, I'm gonna attach them to faders. So to layer more sounds, sorry, you will go here, the plus sign, software instrument, create, pick what sound you want. And that's it. And then I'm gonna do this 2 more times. And then my last sound. And that's it. Now I have four sounds over here. And as you can see, they're all named. Sorry, at the bottom right here. Okay. So if you notice, I'm only going to use four sounds. I know I have eight faders, but I'm going to reserve these faders for something else I'm going to do down the line in this series. Okay, so first you click on the fader that you want to attach a sound to. You go to classical electric piano and then click on volume. And that's that. Click on the next one. The next sound that you want, and then click on volume. And then just do that for all the sounds. Yeah, okay. So hopefully when I hit my keyboard right now, there should be no sound, as there isn't. And when I hit it again, there should be a sound. Okay, try something else. Nice. 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 So I can layer the same note over different sounds. Nice. So that works perfectly fine. So yeah, you can go ahead and do that for all the sounds that you have. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to do is attach these to levels, basically. So what this does is when you play, it actually shows what level you're at. Wait, so I'm just gonna click this, go to the sound, and then click on level. Basically do the same thing that you just did for the volume, but only this time you're clicking level. Last one, level. So now when I play, there's nothing, and now it reads. Now this is good because it can tell me if I'm clipping or not, right? So if it starts to show red, which is not doing that right now, it's like getting to the orange-ish. But when I start to like get to the red, I know that, oh, whoa, my sound is distorting, and I basically do not want that. That's one. And also it looks nice. Like it's nice to know that something's actually reading and sound is actually going out. Okay, so just a quick tip before I move on. I usually like my volume maxed to 0 decibels. I do not like to exceed 0 decibels because I feel anything past 0 decibels, really, it can start to distort, especially when you're layering like multiple sounds and things like that. Okay, so that's great. So now I'm gonna show you how to map your panic button. Okay, so you go here. Well, it's already mapped, but you go to, you click on it, you go to this, and then you go to actions, and then you go to panic here. So that way when you hit the button that you mapped it to on your core controller, it basically like shuts everything off. Next is I'm going to map these to jump between patches. Now this is why I deleted the other ones earlier on, because if I map these buttons to jump between a patch and I don't do it for every single patch that I have, it's not going to jump, if you know what I mean, right? So it's better to just do all your settings in the one patch and then duplicate it, so that way even after you duplicate it, you can change the sound and you can also change the name. So you go click on the button, go to actions, and then click on next patch, and then do the same thing for the other button, actions, and then click on previous patch, right? Yeah. And then the last thing I'm going to show you, I'm really trying to keep this video as short as possible. The last thing I'm going to show you, if you notice around here, it's already like mapped to my CPU load. This is important because I want to know if my computer is about to crash. And if it's about to crash, I need to move to plan B, basically, right? So I click on this, go to actions, and hit CPU load, if I can find it, right here. Perfect. And yeah, that's nice. So, oh, one more thing. I'm just gonna show you quickly how to name your sounds. So if you've noticed, there is no name. And when you're playing like in a gig or like a church, you don't really wanna start doing math to figure out what sound is which. So I'm just gonna show you quickly. So you go to layout and then you go to parameter text. You can make it as big as you want, really. I'm just gonna show you how to do one, and it's basically the same thing over and over again. Okay, so since you only need the text, you don't really need the value, so I just go to text labels, I go to parameter, make sure each word of parameter is showing so that when you put your text in, it doesn't like affect anything. Okay, and then you would go to type, you go to alternating value, because it is going to alternate depending on what sound you're using. And then you would go to number right here, scroll up, and then you click on pitch bend, right? Don't worry, it's not actually going to say pitch bend. I'm going to show you how to change that. So after all that's done, you go to edit, and then you go to, you click on it, it's already clicked on, attributes, replace parameter label, and I'm just going to do E piano. And that's it. So you do the same thing, and then you name your sounds. Obviously, when you change your sounds, you're gonna have to go back and actually replace the text in there. I have unfortunately not found a way for it to defaultly change. I'm sure there's probably a way that makes it easier, but when I find that out, I'm gonna share that with you. If you know, please feel free to drop it in the comments so I can also learn. So yeah, so when I'm done all this, basically I can go here and basically duplicate my set list, and everything just transfers over, and I'm just going here and changing this to, let's say it's like the blessing or something. And then I can go in and change my sounds, basically. So I go here, click on, let's say I want to change this, that I don't want piano anymore and I want strings. I can just go here and pick strings. Oh, it's on the synthesizer. And then pick whatever strings I have. So right now, this is strings. And then I go here, change the name to strings. Yeah, so let me just make sure that these volume levels are back down. So hopefully this works. Right? And remember, now I can actually toggle between each patch, because these already matched out, right? So now I can go to previous patch, right? And then when I go here, it's going to be back to E piano. Let me just make sure that these faders are down. See? And when I go to the next patch, so yeah, so thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any more tips, you can drop them in the comments below. If you have any questions, please drop them in the comments below, and I will try my best to respond to them as quick as possible. And make sure you share this video with anyone who might find this useful. And yeah, thank you guys.